Hi, I'm Tracy Shields, a biomedical librarian at the NIH Library. In this section of searching the literature, we're going to talk about where to search, the databases, and more that you need to consider. But before we get into that, you need to understand what you search when you search. Understand the difference between the platform and a database, and what resources are options for your literature searches, along with some things outside of the normal peer-reviewed literature that you may want to consider. So what you search when you do a search is maybe not what you think it is. Generally speaking, you're not searching full text. In most databases, you're searching a limited set of information based on what's in the database record itself. The database could be a curated collection, so you could be restricting to a specific subject area, who's published it, when it was published, who's providing the database. All of those things may be a factor in what you're searching when you search a database. And what resource you select may depend on your subject area. So let's talk a little bit about platforms and databases. You may be familiar with a database called Medline. It is a bibliographic database that has more than 30 million references to journal articles in life sciences with a concentration in biomedicine. It is produced by the U.S. National Library of Medicine, or NLM, but it is available from multiple providers. You may be more familiar with it as something called PubMed, which is freely available to anyone. But Medline is also available through paid access or subscription resources such as Ovid, EBSCOhost, and other platforms. You can actually do a search of Medline across multiple platforms, and while you would get many of the same things, how you search it and what results you get could be different based on the platform, even though you're searching the same database. So let's talk a little bit about databases. Most databases that you probably would use for research are going to have paid access or a subscription. Many of those databases are by subject areas. So for example, there is a nursing and allied health database called CINAHL that is available through EBSCOhost, which is the platform. There's also a database called PsycInfo, which has more of a focus on psychological, social, and behavioral sciences. InBase is a paid database that focuses on drug and pharmaceuticals. And then there are multidisciplinary databases such as Scopus and Web of Science that are also subscription-based. But there are free options available for you as well. Agricola is an animal and veterinary science food and nutrition database that is freely available on the internet, but may also be on a platform through a subscription. ERIC is also a free database that focuses on education, especially for school-based education, kindergarten through 12th grade. Then there's also options such as Google and Google Scholar, and repositories such as PubMed Central, Europe PubMed Central, and institutional repositories that may be available through specific organizations or universities. Other free options you may want to consider is Global Index Medicus, which is an international database with subsets such as Latin American and Caribbean health sciences literature, or the African Index Medicus. Then there are open access research resources such as CORE, and then SciELO, which has an open access network from 16 different countries, along with resources such as Dimensions and preprint servers. But keep in mind, preprint servers are not yet peer-reviewed, and over time could end up being duplicated in your peer-reviewed databases as well. So where do you start searching? Well, ideally you want to search one of the most comprehensive databases to get the most out of your initial search. PubMed Medline is a great place to start. Some other resources you may want to consider that are very comprehensive include InBase, Scopus, Web of Science, and even Google Scholar. But keep in mind, as I mentioned earlier, that some of these databases, such as Embase, may be fee-based or subscription only. So the type of information you get in the databases may be determined by the resource you pick. Peer review articles are going to be in databases like Medline and EBSCO, EBSCO-CINAHL, but you may also have databases that include things such as gray literature. And that could be something that you may want to consider searching in addition to these databases. So some other gray literature sources you may want to consider are clinical trial registries. Clinicaltrials.gov is produced by the National Library of Medicine and is a primary place to see what research is being done in the US, but also internationally. There are also other international registries you may want to consider, and there are some specific to regions, but also countries. And there's a link here that has a list of clinical trial registries that you may want to look at. Then there are other resources such as organizations, in particular government entities such as regulatory agencies. So for example, if you're doing research on a particular drug, you may want to look at the drug regulatory documents, which would be gray literature, available through the government sources of the country that you're in or that your study is taking part in. Then there's also non-governmental organizations, advocacy or policy groups, and professional organizations. And there's a great list available through the NIH about resources that might be available as part of NGOs. Some other resources you may want to look at are specific to drug information. Lexicomp and Micromedics are two fee-based resources that have great comprehensive information, but some free ones that you may want to consider include PubChem, the Drugs and Lactation Database, or Drug Bank. Then there are also point of care tools. These are evidence-based medicine summaries that you could look at that could help you with some of the discovery of literature, but also provide some expert opinion that is outside the scope of the peer-reviewed literature. And then there's general information sources such as Google Scholar, books and book chapters, and even Wikipedia. A lot of times we think of Wikipedia as the throwaway, not very safe thing to use, but it can be very valuable, especially with certain rare diseases, because that is going to be one of the most comprehensive places available to a lot of people to find that information. So in summary, there are many, many resources out there you can search, and you search a database through a platform. A lot of the comprehensive resources may require paid subscription or fees to access, and many databases may have overlapping content. Even so, it's important, as we've seen in past sections, to have a comprehensive literature search that includes more than one database. And you may want to also consider gray literature sources such as clinical trial registries and preprints and other things as part of your background. So some questions to consider. What resources are available to you? Are they free or are there fees to access them? What is there beyond peer-reviewed articles that would add information and value to your research?
Thank you for listening.